next subtopic under the cutting tool, we are going to discuss tool failure. Tool failure. How cutting tool fail? How the cutting tools are failed? Okay. The failure means the effectiveness of the cutting tool may loss. Okay. Loss of the effectiveness of the cutting tool is called tool failure. So there's a four method to fail the tool. There's a four method to fail the tool. So first one, tool fracture. Tool fracture. Okay. The second one, chipping. Chipping. The next one, deformation. Deformation. The last one, tool wear. Okay, tool wear. These are the four methods to fail the tool. That means the effectiveness, loss of effectiveness because of these four reasons. So what is the tool fracture? Tool fracture. Tool may fracture due to exceeding the ultimate load can it bear. Okay, due to the cutting forces acting on the tool, then when it exceeding this force, it may fail. That means the tool may fracture. Fracture failure. Okay, fracture failure. Okay, then next one, the chipping failure. Chipping failure means loss of material particle wise from the cutting tool. You can see this particle entirely removed from the cutting tool. Okay, loss of material particle wise called chipping. Okay, this is called chipping. You can see the effectiveness of the cutting tool loss due to the chipping. This is common with the ceramic and brittle materials, brittle cutting tools. This is fracture failure, chipping failure, deformation. Deformation means the tool may bend or twist. That means the geometry of the tool deform due to act of forces on it. Okay, deformation. Okay, the next one, the important one is the tool wear, gradual removal of material from the cutting tool called gradual removal of material from the cutting tool is called tool wear in machining. Okay, gradually remove, not particle wise. Okay, tool wear. These are the four methods to fail the tool, cutting tool. The fracture failure due to exceeding the ultimate load acting on it. Then the chipping resistance, the removing the particle wise from the cutting tool, and the deformation, tool may bend or twist. Okay, deformation due to exceeding the force acting on it. Then the wear. Wear is a gradual failure due to removal of material, removing of material from the cutting tool. Okay. Then we are going to discuss among these four methods, we are going to immediately discuss tool wear. There is important failure. We can mathematically model this tool wear. In the first year level, we are going to model this tool wear using the Taylor's tool wear equations. Okay, we are going to discuss in detail about the tool rear. So let's see about tool rear. Then the type of tool rear. Let's see what are the type of tool rear. Tool rear can be classified into three according to the way it happened. Okay, tool rear can be classified into three according to way it happened. Okay, can be classified into three according to way it happened. What are these three ways? What are these three ways? Abrasion tool layer, adhesion tool layer, and diffusion tool layer. The first one, abrasion tool layer. The second one, adhesion tool layer. Third one, diffusion tool. Okay, these are the three methods the wear occur in machining. Okay, wear occur in machining. Maybe a abrasion, adhesion, diffusion tool. Okay, let's see in detail about this tool here. This is the first one I will discuss, abrasion tool layer. What is the abrasion? What is the abrasion? So abrasion tool layer means, let's take the cutting tool. Cutting tool. Then let's take the work material. So I will draw it again. So let's take the I'll draw it again. First one, abrasion tool we are going to discuss with the cutting tool. Let's take with the cutting tool. So this is the work material. And this is the removing chip from the machining. See the finished surface. See the work piece. Okay. Then you can see in this region, this is called secondary shearing zone. This is called primary shearing zone. So then this work material, most of the work material, normally cutting tool material is harder than the work material. Even this cutting tool material is harder than the work material. This work material sometimes contain hard constituents, hard particles, aluminium oxide, cementite, like hard constituent. Okay, hard constituent. What happens when this chip passes over this tool face? This hard constituent penetrate into the tool face and taken out some material from the cutting tool. Okay, let's take, I will enlarge and draw what happened in this area. Okay, with the very high pressure and the temperature, let's take this is the surface of the cutting tool. Then this is the, let's take this is the hard constituent like the aluminium oxide light particle. Okay, when it contact on this surface, it taken out some material. It taken out some material from the cutting tool. Okay, this is how the abrasion tool will occur. This is how the abrasion tool will occur. Okay, then the very small amount removed, but when machine is in a certain longer period, this removal of this material is significant. Okay, that means the tool tip, because of this removal of material, tool geometry may change. That means tool tip become blunt. Okay, then what happened when the tool tip become blunt? The effectiveness of the tool may loss. Okay, so that means it can it produce the poor surface finish and the poor dimensional accuracy. Okay, it is called abrasion tool wear. This abrasion tool wear increases with the temperature. Okay, in a previous lecture we discussed that in every material hardness reduces with the temperature. What happens when temperature increases in this region? This material hardness reduces. Okay, this material hardness reduces. So what happened in face of this this material contacting, it easily flung into the cutting tool material, then it can easily remove the material from the cutting tool. Okay, with the increase of temperature, the abrasion tool wear also increases. Okay, abrasion tool wear increases because hardness with the temperature, there's a drop in hardness of the cutting tool material. Okay, that is the reason. So then by controlling the temperature, abrasion tool wear can reduce. Okay, one of the method to reduce the abrasion tool wear by controlling the temperature, by reducing the temperature in this region. Okay, then the next method we are going to discuss is adhesion tool wear. Adhesion tool wear is common with the machining with the lower cutting speeds. Adhesion tool wear. Adhesion tool wear. Let's take the cutting tool. Okay, let's take the work material. This is the removing chip. This is the finished surface. This is the work material. Okay. Then you can see very high pressure apply on this contacting surface, and also very high temperature develop in this region. Because of this temperature, what happened? The material in this region become plasticity of the material increases. That means in some situation it is molten. Okay, molten. Then what happened with the pressure? With the pressure, there's a possibility to weld this material on this surface instantly. Okay, I will enlarge in this area. Okay, and I'll draw in this way. Okay, then at a certain instantly, this material, the motor material, can weld it to this surface. Okay, so then what happened? This is the removing chip. Then what happened? Instantly welded. Then again it removed from the, with the force, again it removed from the, after subsequently it removed from the weld joint. When it removed from the weld joint, it taken out some material from the cutting tool. is taken out some material from the grinding tool. Okay, this is called adhesion folder, loss of material due to this adhesion process called adhesion tool layer. Okay, again this adhesion tool layer is a common lower cutting speeds and without application of coolant. That means it is also increases with the temperature. Adhesion tool layer increases with the temperature because when increasing the plasticity in this region also cause to generate the weld nugget, more and more weld nugget with the tool face. Okay, when it remove subsequently, when it remove from that weld nugget, it taken out some material. This is how adhesion tool layer okay. Okay, it's a actually it's a time dependent mechanism. Mostly it is common in lower cutting speed, but when increasing the cutting speed, we can avoid generation of this adhesion tool layer. Okay, that means that by selecting the proper cutting tool parameters, we can avoid the adhesion tool layer, and also by controlling the temperature in that region, we can minimize the adhesion tool layer. Okay, then next, the important tool layer method is diffusion tool layer. Diffusion tool layer. Diffusion tool layer. Okay. Diffusion tool layer. The next way of tool layer happening called the diffusion tool layer. Well, let's take the same diagram. The what is meant by the diffusion? The movement of a molecule or atom or particle from high dense region to the low dense region is called diffusion. Natural movement is called diffusion. So normally the cutting tool materials are high dense region, the work material is low dense region. Okay, low dense region. Okay, then what happen with the temperature? More easily these molecules, particles can diffuse into this low dense region from the high dense region. So normally the high dense region is the cutting tool material, then low dense region is the work material. So from the high dense region to the low dense region, the atoms and molecules are diffused. Here you can see, because of this diffusion, the materials are lost from the cutting tools. Okay, this effect is called a diffusion tool layer. Diffusion tool layer. It also increases with the temperature. In every diffusion process, there's an exponential increase in diffusion with the temperature. So it increases with the temperature. By minimizing the temperature, we can reduce the diffusion tool layer. Okay, then here we discuss the three different ways of happening this tool layer: abrasion tool layer, adhesion tool layer, and the diffusion tool layer. The temperature is the important property for these three tool layer operations. If you can minimize the temperature, if you can control the temperature, we can minimize the tool layer. Actually, the temperature is the important parameter governing the tool layer. Okay, in machining, we should control the temperature to minimize the tool layer to give the higher tool life. Okay, then here we discuss way of happening the tool layer. The next, according to the place where it happened, according to the place where it happening on the cutting tool, we can divide into two, called the crater wear and the flank wear. Okay, according to the place where it is happening on the cutting tool, we can call it as, we can divide into two categories, crater wear and the flank wear. okay, straight away and flank. Let's see these, what is the difference, these two. Cutting tool. The work material. Okay. Then in here, the creator via mean creator via develop in this region. Face of the tool. This is called the creator via, loss of material from the tool face. Okay. Creator, yeah. Okay, because of the rubbing action in between the removing chip and the tool face, this wear occur. Okay, this wear occur. Then next wear is this flank wear. The bottom surface, the tool wear due to the rubbing action in between the finished surface and the bottom surface, the cutting tool is called the flank wear. Is called flank wear due to the rubbing action in between the finished surface and the bottom surface of the tool, the flank wear. Okay, then this is how we are divide the tool wear according to where it happened on the, according to the place where it happened on the cutting tool, the flank wear and the crater wear. Okay, okay, then next next we are going to discuss the tool life equation. Okay. Tool life equation. Tool life equation. Okay, tool life equation, we are using the Taylor's tool life equation, Taylor's tool life equation. Okay, we are going to use the Taylor's tool life equation. Okay, the Taylor's tool life equation, we are going to use the Taylor's tool life equation V T N is equal to C. Okay, Taylor's tool life equation. So the T mean the tool life. T mean the tool life. V mean the cutting speed. C is a constant. Wait, C is depend on the various input parameters to the machining process. Depend on the machining parameters. Okay, depend on the machine parameters. That means if C is depend on the machining parameters, for certain machine operation C is a constant. Okay, this C have to determine experimentally. Okay, next N is also constant, basically depend on, N is basically depend on cutting tool materials. Okay, N is depend on the cutting tool material, basically depend on the cutting tool material. Okay, so for the N values, this is how we are relating this tool life with the cutting speed, tool life with the cutting speed with the constant Cn in. For the n, n is a constant depending on the cutting tool material. There's a typical values are given. Typical n values are given for the cutting tool materials. 2 material, then the typical n values. So let's take the commonly using cutting tool materials. What are the n values? First one, HSS. Typical n values ranging from 0.8 to 0.2, depending on the type of tool, alloying composition and so on, and also type of cut we are doing. This is it also depends on the type of cut we are doing, rough cut or finish cut. This is depend. So in this, the cast cobalt alloy. It is ranging from 0.1 to 0.15. Okay. Then with the carbide tools, ranging from 0.2 to 0.5. Ceramic tools is ranging from 0.5 to 0.7. Okay. The n is not only depend on the cutting tool material, it also depend on the type of cut, some other machine parameters. Okay, these are the typical ranges depending on the cutting tool material. Okay, n. Then let's see how to use this equation to for the calculations. Okay, let's move to the example. Let's understand the use of this cutting tool tool life equation with the example. Okay, this is the first problem we are going to discuss. They calculate the cutting speed for a tool to have a tool life of 160 minutes. Okay, the same tool had a tool life of 9 minutes when cutting at 250 meters per minute. That n value is given, take n is equal 0.22. The n is depend on the cutting tool material, basically depend on the cutting tool material, and also it also depend on the some machining parameters also. Okay, but the n value have to give for this one has given. Then what is the tool life equation? Okay, Vt n is equal c. Okay, the V cutting velocity, T machine time, T mean the tool life, N is a constant, depend on the cutting tool material, the C is a constant, depend on other parameters other than cutting speed. Okay, C is depend on the other parameters except V velocity. Actually the C constant, what happened except to this example, what happened tool life is equal to 1, V is equal C. What it mean? C mean the cutting speed which gives tool life of 1 minute, unit time. Cutting speed, it is numerically equal to the cutting speed which gives tool life of unit time. Okay, except to this example. Okay, then calculate the cutting speed for two different situations are given. The C is a common term, we can equate the C. We can add the two equations for two different cases. Let's take the tool life had a tool same tool has a tool life of 9 minutes when cutting with the 250 meters per minute. For the second situation, I'm going to put the Taylor's equation. 250 meters per minute. Then the T, the tool life is given 9 into N is a constant. Equation 1. Okay. Then the problem is asking to what is the speed? What is the kinetic speed which can give 160 meters per minute? Sorry, 160 tool life. In this time, the 160, so actually this one we can put the n is equal 0.22. Okay. The 160, the tool life is needed, 160 minute tool life is needed, 0.22. Then the type of cut is same, type of cutting tool material is same, so the n is common term. C, we are also assuming the same for these two operations. C, only we are assuming the only cutting speed is vary, so C is common for the both the operations. So we have to determine the, we have the two equations, sorry, we have two equations, then we can find the V. So then from 1 and 2, I am going to equate these two equations. Okay. From 1 and 2, yeah, 250, 9 into 0.22 is equal V into 160 to 0.22. okay, use your calculators to find the V is equal 250 into 0.22 divided by 160 into 0.22. okay, use your calculators to find the new cutting velocity, we use 160 minute. Okay. This one also we can write 250 into 9 divided by 160 into 0.22. The answer is 132.73 meters per minute. Okay, this is the answer. So what it means? It means if you can early the tool life is 9 minutes with the 250 meters per cutting speed. If you reduce it to a 132.73, we can get the 160 minute tool life. You can see the slight drop of cutting speed, you can increase the tool life in a higher portion, higher ratio. So I think you all more clear with this example. Okay. Within the second example, we will discuss this one. Okay. Example 2. The cutting tool cutting at 25 meters per minute gave a tool life of 1 hour. With rough cut, what will be the probable tool life when engaged on a finished cut with the same speed? To do this problem, the two n values have to give. Okay, two n values have to give. The n for that is given for rough cut. Rough cut, n is equal 1 over 10 for finish cut. Okay, you can see this n value is not only depend on the type of cutting tool material, it also depend on the type of cut we are producing. Type of cut we are producing. The here we have to do one assumption. The C is common for the both operation. This is the here yeah assumption. Okay. Then here we are in the two different cases. I am going to put the Taylor's tool life equation for these two different cases. Vtn is equal to C. The first case, cutting at 22 meters per minute gave a tool life of 1 hour. Okay, with the rough cut. Okay, 22 cutting speed for first situation, 22 into tool life 60 minute. What is the n? It is equal for the rough cutting 1/8. It's a constant. Here we have to assume for this problem we have to assume the C is constant. Actually the other properties are not vary. The cutting only the cutting speed is vary. The other properties are not vary. So C we are assuming as a constant. Okay, not vary. Then what will be the this probable tool life when engaged on the light finish cut with the same speed? Speed is same. 22 meters per second. Then the T we have to calculate. The n value is 1/10. C is a constant. Equation 2. The same as in previous, we can equate this to equation. Okay, then we can write two equations. 22 into 60 into 1/8 is equal 22 into t into 1/10. You can cut these values easily. So then you can see you can solve in this way by making to make t into subject. What we have to do, you have to take the 10th power. That means the t is equal 60 into 10/8. Then the t, use your calculators to find the t. It is equal to 167 minute. Okay, you can see in a finish cut with n is equal 1/10, the tool life is 167. Earlier it is 1 hour, 60 minute. Okay. This is how we are use this how we are using this tool Taylor's tool life equation to calculate the tool life and cutting speeds. Okay, tool life and the cutting speed. Okay, let's continue on next day class. Thank you.